Hi everyone, Marine here. I'm so glad to be back with the Card Fallen Fawn, and today I'm taking you to a tiki bar to have a cocktail, something sweet and refreshing to celebrate summertime. First thing first, let's check out the supplies I used on this card. To Candu It for some tropical leaves. How You Been for the jar. Critters in the Jungle for the fern and flower. Life is Good for the seashell. Bubbles of Joy to make my cocktail sparkling. A Bug Deal to create mint leaves. Sweet Friends for the three little strawberries. So Smooth for the ice cubes and strawberries again. Sweet Christmas to make straws. On the Beach for the parasol. And Simply Celebrate Summer for my sentiment. I also used the Simple Stripes Landscape die, the biggest die from the Large Stitch Rectangle Stackables die set, and the smallest die from Everyday Sentiment Banners. The Tropical Leaves background stencils as well, and the paper from the Watercolor Wishes Rainbow Paper Pack. As always, I started with the coloring, and these are my images that I stamped using jet black ink. And as always, again, I used my graphite brush markers and spectrum noir markers to color everything. And it's been a while since my last shaker card, so later in the video, I will show you how I turned my strawberry cocktail into a strawberry shaker cocktail. So once my images were done, I moved on to my strawberry cocktail. The first thing I did was to stamp and cut a jar. And to make the inside, I used a paper from the watercolor Wishes Rainbow Paper Pack. But just by placing the paper behind the jar, we can see the white border inside the jar. So to fill the entire jar, I stamped the image a second time on the watercolor paper. I placed the paper in my Misty tool with the stamp on top, picked up the stamp with the door of my Misty tool, and then stamped the jar. Stamped it twice to get a nice impression using jet black ink. Next, I fussy cut the image. I cut right on the black lines. And here you can see that the whole jar is filled with watercolor paper that is going to be my strawberry cocktail. So I attached the fussy cut pink jar on top of the die cut jar. I just applied a bit of liquid glue on the lid and on the inside white borders. I set the jar aside to let the glue dry, and then I created a window opening into the jar using the coordinating die. I flipped the jar over to make sure that the image was aligned with the die and used pieces of washi tape to keep everything in place. Sent it to my die cut machine and I tore the paper a little bit when I removed the washi tape. But this part will be hidden, so it was fine. Next, I built my shaker cocktail. I have my image on the left. Next, we have a white jar base and an acetate jar. Both were cut using the plain die. Next, we have a foam jar that I will use to create dimension and room for the shaker pieces that you can see on the right. And I also used some polymer clay strawberries from my stash. So I started by applying liquid glue at the back of the pink die cut element. I placed the pink jar on top of the white base and attached the pink die cut element right in the middle. I removed the pink jar and then stuck the foam element on the white base. I applied liquid glue directly on the white base all around the pink center and then attached the foam jar. I set it aside to dry and created the window. I applied glue at the back of the pink jar and attached the acetate element. Next, I filled the jar with my small images, strawberries, ice cubes, bubbles, polymer clay strawberries, and I also added a few clear sequins to make the cocktail even more sparkling. I applied liquid glue on the foam edges and then placed the window on top to finally complete my strawberry shaker cocktail. Next step was to create the background of my tiki bar, and I used the Simple Stripes background landscape die to create wood planks. The paper is paper bag cardstock, and to bring more texture to give the illusion of a worn out wood panel, I used these dressings. I separated the 5 stripes and started by applying some vintage photo on the 4 edges of each stripe. It will give more interest and bring more depth to my tiki background. So I inked up the 5 pieces and then decided to add even more contrast by applying some Grand Espresso, but just on the very edges of each stripe, just by rubbing my blending tool on the edges. Next, I kept my wood planks all together using washi tape at the back. And to give my panel some Hawaiian vibes, I used the tropical leaves background stencils. I taped the first stencil, the one with the biggest leaves, taped it at the back of the panel, and you can notice that I centered my panel in the middle of the stencil. and also that I lined up the bottom of the stencil with the bottom of my panel. And next I just applied vintage photo distressing to cover my panel with tropical leaves. So here we have my panel with some spots with no leaves. I just used the second stencil to fill those spaces. And to make sure that the stencils coordinate perfectly on the paper, I just placed the Lanfone signature at the bottom of the panel, just like what I did with the first stencil. So I taped that second stencil at the back of my panel. I made sure that it wasn't overlapping with the first leaves. And then used the vintage photo distressing again to fill the spaces and totally complete my tiki bar background. I removed the stencil and voila, we have a gorgeous wood plank panel to set up my cute cocktail scene. I cut a card base out of peacock cardstock and attached my wood planks panel on top. And I also needed something to put my cocktail on, so I cut a simple rectangle out of wood grain cardstock. I added a bit of the same distressings as before on the edges and attached it at the bottom of my panel. I also white heat embossed my sentiment on a piece of fake tan cardstock, used a banner die to cut it, and attached that banner at the bottom of my panel as well using foam squares. And next it was time to assemble everything, and I started with the cocktail. I attached the mint leaves, the parasol, the straws, some ice cubes and strawberries, as well as bubbles using liquid glue and glue dots. Next, I stick the elements on my background, starting with some tropical leaves and then the cocktail. I added the toucan on top of the straw and more leaves, bubbles, flowers, a seashell and strawberries. Once everything was attached on my panel, I added a white nouveau drop in the center of each yellow flower. And the card was done. I hope you like it. Now it's time to sit at the bar and enjoy some quiet time with a refreshing cocktail. Thank you so much for watching and see you very soon. Have a good day. Bye.